We do not honor what is known as an ICE detainer, meaning a letter or an email or even a phone call that ICE might give us and send to us and say, hey, we want to you for you to hang on to John Smith, and you know, we'll be down tomorrow, or you know, it's 10 o'clock on 10 p.m. and we're going to be down tomorrow at 8 p.m. or 8 a.m. to get them. No, we won't do that. If someone is, and this is part of the decision, if someone goes to court or someone is arrested and they have an inherent bail or a bail that's imposed by the judge, or they're being released from court by a judge, they then return to our detention facility. And then as a matter of process, and it's not just simply that we open the doors and away they walk out. They've got uniforms on, there's medical things that need to be cared for, there's appointments that need to be set up, there's a lot of different things that have to happen before we can release someone and just let them go out the door. So generally it might take an hour and a half, ballpark, as an average, potentially 2 hours in some situations depending on the case. Before someone might be, from the time that they were determined that their bail is being paid or that they've been released from the detention center, that they then would be actually walking out the door.